Hi, this is video 6 of the series of working in the round with interwoven crochet, where I cover all possibilities that you can encounter. This one is quite similar to the previous video, so I already did my start and I already positioned my my markers. And well, one little tip, maybe I don't know if I did it in my English or Dutch videos, because I do them in both languages. When you see, when you have this circle that you close, then you can have a gap here. It helps to really tighten that first chain, so that already helps, but you can also correct it later when finishing your ends. Let's see again what we have to do. This time in this series, in this part of 4 videos, we have to put row 1A to the back, so we put the white in front of it, and then I have to see what happens next. Color 2 has to be put to the back, so we have here our color 2, we put that to the back, and then we can close our round here of row 1A, and here we 1, 2, 3, and then we close it 1, 2, 3, 4. And actually, this is a situation that is not explicitly covered in my ebook, because it's, well, quite similar to the previous one. But this will be a situation that will be in my call, so that is why I'm showing it now in this video. And well, let's continue to row 1B. Okay, we will do row 1B. I see that I forgot my purple marker, so I will put the in that here again, always at the right side of your first chains. And here we have our starting position again, the color 1 in the middle and color 2 to the right of it. And then the instructions say that we have to put color 1 to the front. So we take this and we put it to the front. And then we have to do back 2 times at each side. So we already did that first one. And then we go to the corner with the red marker and work at the back side. 1, 2, 3, 4, then we go to the other side and we finish our corner here at the and work at the other side of the red marker, our in between chain, and then we go to the corner with the yellow marker. First work at the right side of the yellow marker at the back. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we go to the other side and do our 2 back double crochets, and the first one in the first corner with the yellow marker, in between chain, and then our second double crochet on this side, and then a corner. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then to the last side, first finish that corner with the green marker, in between chain, and then we have come to our last corner here with the purple marker, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and like always, this is color 2, we don't have to get past color 1, so we can simply close are round here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I didn't reposition my markers at this moment. And well, I will do that now. And, well, I will do my first one. So I connect the outer two corners. And I like to do often just take a new marker and reposition and then take out the other one. And sometimes it's just easier to get to keep everything in place. So I will take out my markers, reposition them, and then I will get back to you. So up to row 2A, and it says front, back and corner. So we did our front already, back, 1, 2, 3, 4, and it says back, front, back, then so back, front, and this is easy because I will show that in a moment. Back, front, back, 1, 2, 3, 4. You know, here that stitch that we did here in the top of the double crochet here, it's in between this hole, in between those double crochet in the white. But in this situation, it is already positioned quite correctly when you're at it, as you can see again in a moment. So back. So here's what I mentioned, what I meant. So you see here, this double crochet is already neatly positioned between those two white ones, and that is not always the case. So, and I have encountered that situation already in a couple of other videos. So, well, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then again a back, from back, back, front, and back again, and this is our last corner. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we have to end with back one time. And this time we have to put color 2 to the back. So, well, it was already hanging there. So, and then we can close our round with color 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's remove the markers. And here we have our middle part. And also take a look at the back, if it looks correctly. So then we will have to do two more videos to cover all the situations, and well, see you back in the next video.